Once again, we have here with us Dr. Swapnil. Dr. Swapnil had scored rank 3 in November AIIMS 2012. This time, Dr. Swapnil has scored rank 41 in NEET and rank 4 in DPG. Congratulations, Dr. Swapnil.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Swapnil is doing surgery at AIIMS. Happy?
Very, very happy.
And any plans of changing? Now you've got a very good rank.
Not at all.
Okay, so Dr. Swapnil is pretty satisfied working at AIIMS in the surgery department. Dr. Swapnil, you were the first initial people who wrote the NEET, right? And at the same time, you have been able to score a very good position. Can you please inform your juniors and friends, what kind of preparation did you have for NEET?
I would just like to tell ki from the very beginning onwards, when I started preparing, like in the earlier days of my internship, when I started focusing towards my PG entrance exams, I had a thing in mind, like I won't be doing anything extra for any particular exam, be it AIIMS, be it PGI, be it All India, since at that time NEET was not announced. So I just kept a plan, I would be doing these 19 subjects, these topics from each subject, and I'll be just going with it. And I made a timetable according to it. And then later on the way, NEET was also announced that we are going to have a completely different, and that was actually quite a panicky situation.
Yeah, it was a sudden announcement.
That was a chaotic thing.
Yeah.
So, but then still at that time we didn't have much time, so I decided not to change my approach, just go with the flow. What I am doing, just do that. So I just went in with that thing, and actually I was not sure for NEET, because I thought ki, okay, I am taking a risk, I am not doing anything extra like many people were. So I thought, chalo koi nahi, I'll just give it a try this time, and next time maybe if I don't succeed this time, I'll try next time with a different approach. But to get to know the results, even post exams I was not sure, but when I got to know my results, I was really very satisfied and happy to know just one thing, ki what I had thought from the beginning, my approach worked towards it.
So what was the approach? What exactly was your approach that the student would like to know?
My approach was pretty
that means that you did not have a different approach to NEET, but still you were able to make it at AIIMS, and you were also able to make it at NEET. So what was the preparation?
It was very simple. Like, you have all the 19 subjects, you should have this thing clearly written down in your mind that we are all humans. At the end day, on the judgment day, you cannot know all the 19 subjects by heart, you cannot know the details of all the 19 subjects by heart. If you are very good at one subject, then you are definitely going to be very bad at some other. So you have to strike a balance, which will finally work out for you. And this is the thing which, if you keep in your mind, you do the basic topics of all the 19 subjects, just the basic topics which are asked repeatedly over and over again, and the basic topics which you know can be asked. If you cover those topics, you will definitely succeed, what I think.
Okay, Dr. Swapnil, how is it that your coaching at Dr. Bhatia Medical Institute helped you, apart from your own preparation?
Adding further on to what I was saying, now to know that out of these 19 subjects, there are immense number of topics, you have to go through so many things. Which topics are you going to select, what all are you going to read in this limited time? This is where the role of a good coaching institute comes. In my case, it was Dr. Bhatia's Medical Institute. So I actually started doing Dr. Bhatia's from my earlier days only, and it has helped me groom the entire way. It helped me know, like, in different subjects, like for example, maybe I would say dermatology, it helped me know ki, okay, there are certain chapters like vesicobulary disorders, they come in exams very frequently and questions are being asked, and there are some topics from which questions are never asked. So why to waste my energy doing that? It is better you get more focused on one topic, and okay, and the thing is, you are getting more focused on it, okay, but the coaching institute also give you information on the other topics as well. So if you read that minimal thing from the other topics and a more deep information for this required topic, you will get through. And it is the thing with all the 19 subjects, because at the end you need to have a comprehensive syllabus from which you can get your things and appear in an examination.
How did the faculties at Dr. Bhatia Medical Institute teach you?
The faculty at Bhatia Medical Institute had a very comprehensive approach. Like, they had both the anti-grade and the retrograde approach while we were being taught the things. Like, say in ortho, we are getting to know, we are reading about any topic, fractures. So we were being taught also like the important topics which are being asked in the examinations frequently over and over again. And also meanwhile you are being given information about our basic knowledge, like which we should know as being a medical student. So that way it helps you know both the retrograde approach, so that you come to know your objectives and everything. You are appearing for regular tests on the classroom, in the classrooms. So this is the retrograde part, and the anti-grade part is you are being given the theoretical knowledge. So this helped us a lot.
What about the one-liners? How were you able, when you saw the one-liners, did you feel that this is something that has been already covered or anything?
Yes, I would say this, because see, if you want that there should be a separate book, there should be separate 4-5 volumes where one-liners can be written, you can grasp all those things, then it is never going to happen, because from our syllabus, there can be crores and crores of one-liners and you can never learn them. The thing is, you should need to know that there is a topic, there are 10 lines about it. Only one of those lines would be coming to you as a one-liner, as one of your questions in your paper. So, if you are being taught those 10 things, like anywhere, in a college, in a coaching institute, anywhere, if you are being taught those things, you will definitely be doing your questions correctly.
So, were these one-liners, or you can say, were these highlighters being taught to you at the institute?
Yeah, definitely.
You found them?
Yeah, they were always, because in anything, what I would say, I cannot say obviously 100% I was being taught everything out of 10 out of 10 topics, but yeah, definitely most of the time, 95-96% times, I was being taught 9 out of 10 topics, 10 in sentences about that topic. So, that gives you a major chance of getting it correct.
So, right, that's good enough. Finally, something special that you would like to convey in short to your juniors who are now going to write the NEET?
In short, I would just like to say, there, from my experience only, that there are two things I would like to say. Firstly, from my own experience, that do all the subjects, don't compromise on any of the subjects. You never know which subject is going to be asked in the exam, and do cover the basic things. Join some coaching institute which you know is good and which will help you go forward, and which will help you cover your topics. And secondly, also keep doing objectives. Solve good books of objectives. There are several books available. And don't just rely on the AA and AAA books, which are the traditional things, because I don't think if you just rely on that, you are just going to get through. So get your theory background also strong.
You were saying something about medicine essence.
This book actually I found quite useful, because see, medicine is a subject which covers lot of other subjects as well. It covers your pathology, it covers your pharmacology, it covers medicine as well, it covers dermatology, psychiatry, and maybe some others. Microbiology. So, Medicine Essence was a very good book, because what I found was the way the things were explained in the question answer format, or the first text, then some questions were given at the back and the explanation was given. So, you can actually reading through the explanation, you get to know, okay, about this topic we have these 10 lines. You get into your habit, okay, if you are preparing for NEET, get into the habit of extracting those lines. You will do good, and it is a good book to go with.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Swapnil. Thank you very much.